My parents did not practice religion at home because my father was Taoist or Buddhist. My mother was actually Catholic. So I was not baptized Catholic, but my mother, being a smart lady, sent me to Montfort School, which is a Catholic school. And then I became interested in the religion. I asked my father for permission, which he did not give. So when I went to Newcastle for my university, upon the age of 21, I decided that I would get myself baptized. So I was baptized in Newcastle. The priest at the chapel at Newcastle University, there's one thing that I remember him telling me, and that is, distinguish between form and substance. So form is what we see a lot of in society. But what is more important is the substance behind the form. If there is no substance, then it rings hollow. So forget the trappings of status, you know, of wealth and so on, but what is the substance that is behind any act that you do? I think that's one of the guiding principles for me in life. To talk about servant leadership, one of the significant acts that Christ did was the washing of feet. And the message that he gave to his apostles and disciples was that the leader should serve. So I think the concept of servant leadership derives from how Christ taught his disciples and how Christ provided the example or the model that one should follow. We first have to ask ourselves, in whatever we do, what is the purpose? What purpose drives what you do? If you're clear in your purpose, then that guides what should be done by you and your colleagues, your supporters. A very simple statement of purpose is, how can I be useful to others? That guided me in my work in NTUC. How can I be useful to workers, members of the trade union movement? And then currently, in my role as chairman of Temasek Holdings, how can I be useful to the country in the management of the wealth of the country? I have always taken it as a matter of course. If you are required to give of your time, if you think you are able, do it. If you find purpose and meaning in work, it becomes enjoyable. You derive great satisfaction if you succeed. So in that sense then, it doesn't feel like a sacrifice. Making sacrifices in the public service is something regularly you have to do. It means sacrifice of time, of yourself, sacrifice of your time of your family. That's part of the cost. And I go back to the priest at Newcastle University. He says, God is everywhere. And all you have to do is, whenever you have a moment, right, to pray to Him. Pray to Him can mean just talk to God in your mind. You don't have to voice it out. When you have that moment of peace and quiet, just do that. And that's, generally speaking, how I've lived my life and my faith, because, you know, my work takes a lot of my time, and but within all that, I just then switch off everything else, and a couple of minutes, that's all you need.